Hello viewers, welcome to my channel Pharmacypedia. In this video, we are going to discuss about a very interesting topic, that is about the hard gelatin capsules. This video is going to be beneficial for both D-Pharm and B-Pharm students. So let us begin. So hard gelatin capsules, when we talk about the solid dosage forms, there are two dosage forms which have been very important for the pharmacist, and they are very easy to dispense. The first is the tablet and second is the capsules. So these two dosage forms are very popular dosage forms from very beginning, from the initiation of the pharmacy. So they both have their advantages and disadvantages associated with them. So in this video, I am going to discuss specifically about the hard gelatin capsules. So hard gelatin capsules, as the name specifies, is a solid dosage form in which one or more than one medicinal substance is enclosed in a small shell prepared from the suitable form of the gelatin. So depending on the formulation, the gelatin capsule shells may be hard or soft capsules. So friends, you can see in the picture that these are the empty gelatin capsule shells. These gelatin shells are derived from the collagen of various animal and plant sources. So these empty gelatin capsule shells are basically used for the preparation of gelatin capsules. These are the outer shells, and in these, this shell is basically comprised of two parts, body and the top part, cap part. So body and the cap part. So you fill actually your desirable material, which is composed of your active ingredient along with some other excipients, in the body of the capsule, and you cap out this body of the capsules and you squeeze it out so that you have a single unit dosage form. So it is very convenient for the patient to either take capsule or the tablets. Now the specific advantages associated with the capsule is that, first of all, it is a single unit dosage forms. Very convenient for the patient to take it. So in another words, it is having high patient compliance. And moreover, the medicaments need not to be compressed. When you talk about the formulation development of tablet, in tablet, what you do actually, you take out the active ingredients along with the excipients, and you do either dry or wet granulation and you compress it. This technology is not used in the capsule formulation. So capsule formulation technology is simple in a way that you have a powder with you. You have a solid powder composed of active ingredient, which may be one or more than two, along with the excipients. So you are mixing all the things. Now you have a dried loose powder. So this loose powder is then filled up in these gelatin capsule cells. Now the advantage is that there is no need for the compression. So in a single machine, you on one side your capsule formula is being prepared, another side you are adding down the capsule shells, and they are being filled up into the unit dosage forms. So you can see the structure of a individual capsule shell. It is having the body part and the cap part, and you can see the ring type structure also, like tapered ring, locking ring, whereby it is being sealed out. Now, as discussed, the main advantage which is associated with the capsule is that, first of all, it masks the unpleasant taste of a drug. If suppose there is a drug which is having the unpleasant or undesirable taste, it will not be beneficial to take it in the form of a tablet. In that case, the desired dosage form would be capsule, because the taste could be easily masked by covering it with a gelatin capsule shells. So while you are actually inhaling, you are swallowing the capsule shells, you will not feel that unpleasant taste or the odor. So it is being masked out. This is the very first advantage of the capsules. Then second is that as I have told, it is in a powderous form. You don't need to go for the compression cycle, compressed as you do in the case of the tablet. So second most important advantage with the capsule is that no need for the compression. In an uncompressed loose powder form, the medicaments are being taken by the patient. So, and it has another advantage also, like when you compress the tablet, you need to undergo the dissolution and disintegration test. although you do the same kind of the test for capsules as well, but it takes time for them to disintegrate. So you are in a way actually doing double cycle, like first formulating it into the compressed form, that is in the form of tablet, and then seeing how, in how much time it disintegrates. So that problem will not be here in that evaluation part, because in capsules already it is in a powdered form, so there is no compressed form or powdered, so it will be easily absorbed into the intestinal system. It will be easily absorbed into the stomach. So bioavailability would be immediate. Then third part is the flexibility, which provides the wide prescription. Capsule is very popular form of the medicament. It is being used and over prescribed to large number of the patients because of its ease of administration, because it contains accurate dosage forms into the individual dosage form. So when we talk about the accuracy, accuracy is said to be more in the capsules than compared to the tablets, because there the chances of weight variations are more. Here dosage form formulation is simple enough. You have the active ingredient along with the excipient, mixing them properly, homogeneous mixture, and then filling it into the capsule gelatin shells. Now, it is also being found that it is easier for some people to swallow capsule than as compared to the tablet. And moreover, these capsules can be designed in a way there whereby you can have the controlled release rate of the drugs. What does this mean? You want your drug to be released over a specified period of your time. You want to control the drug release. That can also be done and customized in the case of the capsules. Another advantage is that little pressure is required to compact the material. As compared to the tablet, as there is no compression stage, so the capsule dosage forms are easily to make, and they are again a very popular dose which is being prescribed to large number of consumers. And also it requires less number of excipients as compared to the tablets. Why? So because you don't need magnesium stearates here, you don't need lubricants that much extra. You need some subs as compared to the tablet dosage form. Capsules required less number of the excipients. Now there are certain disadvantages which is associated with the capsules. It has been found that it is not suitable for highly soluble substances like potassium chloride, potassium bromide, ammonium chloride, etc. The reason is that when we see the properties of the gelatin, that in gelatin you have to keep the moisture in a certain ratio, that is about 13 to 15% of the moisture is being kept inside the capsules. Now, if you have a very highly soluble substance, what will happen? It will absorb the moisture from the gelatin. So again, making the gelatin very hard, very cracky. So the desired attribute will be lost. It may break down. So it is not, the capsule dosage form is not recommended for the formulation of very highly soluble substances like potassium chloride, potassium bromide, ammonium chloride, etc. Second, it is also not considered to be suitable for highly efflorescent or deliquescent substances, because the efflorescent substances may cause the capsule to become too soft, because efflorescent substance will be releasing the moisture content, will be releasing the water content, and this will be absorbed by the gelatin coat and it will become soft. Or deliquescent substance, they will extract out the moisture from the gelatin coat. So what will happen? The gelatin shell will become very dry and leading to the cracking problem. And moreover, when we talk about the capsules as compared to the tablets, you require specific storage condition. For example, the relative humidity which is required to store the capsules is about 40 to 50%, and the moisture content required is in the gelatin strand that has to be maintained is between 13 to 16%. So as compared to the handling of the tablets, they are not robust that much. You need to maintain the temperature and relative humidity conditions so that you can have it in a proper form. The defects in the tablet in the capsules is like cracking of the capsules or like swelling of the capsules may happen if the desired moisture is not being maintained. The concentrated solutions which require dilutions are unsuitable for capsules. So the concentrated solutions which further requires dilutions are not suitable to be stored in the form of the capsules. I hope now you are clear about the main advantages and disadvantages of the capsules as compared to the tablets. Next we move, what are the ideal requirements for the capsules? When we talk about the capsules, there are two things basically which we will be discussing. First is the shell and second is the medicament. So when we talk about the gelatin shell, it should disintegrate in the presence of digestive fluid so that the contents are released. Since there is no compression in the case of capsules, the medicament along with the excipient is being enclosed in a shell. So when we talk about the disintegration or dissolution of the capsules, first digestive fluid will come into the contact of the shell. Now if the shell does not break, the medicament will not be able to come out easily. So the desired property is that the shell strength, the shell properties should be like that once it comes into the contact of the digestive fluid, it should break down fast so that the medicaments powdered form will be released for the absorption. Second, the content should not cause deterioration of the shell. Whatever contents are being inside the gelatin capsule, it should not be allow the deterioration of the external shell. Third, there should not be any incompatibility between the medicaments and the gel. So if there is any sort of the incompatibility, again there will be interaction and it will not release to the release of the medicament as per the plan. So and further, the material which is being enclosed, it should be non-toxic. It should be economical so that the pricing could be controlled. See, the very one reason for the popularity of tablets as well as the capsule was that they both were very economical. They both could be formulated very fast at very high speed, and they could be formulated fast. So the reasons was one of the factor that promoted these dosage forms were their economic nature. So I think I'm clear with the ideal requirements. The shell should disintegrate in the presence of digestive fluids immediately so that the medicaments can come out. It should not cause deterioration of the shell medicaments. There should not be any incompatibilities between both the sides, like gelatin as well as the medicament, and it should be non-toxic in the nature. Now this is the preparation of gelatin. As I've told, gelatin is basically derived from the bones, calf skin and pork skin. That is why the issue of vegetarian comes in between when you talk about taking of capsules as compared to a tablets, because they are derived from the animal sources, calf skin and pork skin, and from the dried bones. Now you can see the method of preparation of gelatin. When dried bones, they are exposed and capped in 5% hydrochloride solution for 10 to 15 days. Then then the dicalcium phosphate is being taken out from that, and they are being exposed to lime composed of 10% for a period of 4 to 8 weeks. Then this lime is again removed and the pH adjustment is being done. Second, from the calf skin, the skin is being washed out, kept in the lime solution 10% for 6 to 12 weeks. Then again, it is washed, rinsed and kept for 10 to 30 hours. Then pork skin, it is being exposed, washed and kept in hydrochloric acid for 10 to 30 hours, and the acid is being removed. So these are the three preparation pathways for getting the gelatin. Now the gelatin formulation, the gelatin product which is obtained by the above three sources is by the partial hydrolysis of the collagen which is derived from the skin, white connective tissues and bone of the animal. So it is actually the collagen. It is a protein. Gelatin is a protein commercially made by the partial hydrolysis of the collagen from the skin, bones and connective tissues of animals such as cattle, chicken, pork, fishes, horses. So apart from the calf and the pork skin, other two animals from which the gelatin can be easily derived is the fishes and the horse skin. So these skin are then washed and then kept in the lime or either hydrochloric acid for a specified period of time. Then they are being rinsed and the collagen is being removed from that. So that there are basically two types of the gelatin. First is type A and second is type B. Now, what is the property of the type A is that it is derived from the acid-treated precursor that exhibits an isoelectric point at pH 9. So, it is derived after once it is being acid, once the collagen is being treated with the acid, for example hydrochloric acid, which is having an isoelectric point at pH 9. So it is mainly manufactured from the pork skin. If you remember, if the pork skin was exposed to 1-5% of hydrochloric acid for 10-30 hours for getting this type A gelatin skin type. Then second type of the gelatin is derived from the alkali treated precursor. What was the alkali treated precursor? It was the lime solution. It was kept in lime solution for a specified period of the time. So when I showed you that preparation of gelatin, you must have seen two chemicals were exposed. First was the lime and second was the hydrochloric acid. So when we treat it with hydrochloric acid, we call it type A gelatin is being obtained, and when it is treated with the lime, that exhibits an isoelectric point at pH 4.7, it is called type B gelatin is being obtained. So the type B gelatin is obtained, manufactured mainly from the animal bones. Now, when we talk about the hard gelatin capsules, there are certain properties. Like these gelatin capsules are not only the collagen, only the protein which is obtained from the animal and bone sources. Along with that, certain other agents are being added, like sugar and water. They are being added up along with the plasticizer to keep the integrity of the shell. The gelatin obtained must be clear, colorless, and the colors can be added with various dyes and essentially tasteless. So when we talk about the general, it is tasteless, colorless in a raw form, but it can be colored using various types of the chemical substances, opacants like titanium dioxide. So the most commercially available medicated capsules contain combination of colorants and opacants to make them distinctive. So like opacants are the substances which add opacity or the darkness or the color to the empty gelatin shells. So when you have the opacity darkness, titanium dioxide is generally used for this purpose. Now gelatin is also obtained by the partial hydrolysis of the collagen obtained from the skin, white connective tissues and the bones of the animals. The hard gelatin capsule shells is desirable to maintain the hard gelatin capsules in an environment free from the excessive humidity. So the very important thing in the case of the capsule is that the moisture has to be limited into the range of 13-16% while handling the capsules. The reason being that they are, when you have the extra moisture, it will be absorbed by the medicament, and if the medicament is having extra moisture or it is having very dry, it will extract the moisture from the gelatin shells. So in that way, if you have to see, keep both the things intact, you want your gelatin shell as in a proper shape and you want your medicament to be safe from the extra moisture, you need to control the moisture of the gelatin shell. Now many capsules are packaged along with a small packet of desiccant material so that extra moisture can be absorbed by them to protect them from the absorption of the atmospheric moisture. So the desiccant material generally used is like dried silica, gel, clay, activated charcoal, etc. Now the size of the capsules. Now capsule size again is very important. It is basically into 8 types, ranging from 000, first, second, 00, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So when we, in case of, you have to remember one thing very carefully, that is that capsule size is actually reverse in nature. So the 000 here refers to the largest size of the capsules, whereby the number 5, although the number 5 is large in number, but when we talk about the 8 capsules, it is having the smallest size. So the largest size, you have to memorize this, you have to, this is very important, generally asked in the examination also, as in competitive examination also, that what is the largest capsule size, it is number 000. What is the smallest size, it is number 5. So general standard shape of the capsule is traditional symmetrical shape. So when we talk about the hard gelatin capsules, it is having a typical cylindrical shape, but soft gelatin capsules are found to have different shapes. So here we are discussing only the hard gelatin capsules. So three things again very important: largest size of the capsule is 000, smallest size is 5, and this ideal shape, standard shape, is symmetrical shape. So like again, when we talk about the volume of the substance which can be stored in these shells, for example, in 000 capsule size, 1.37 ml of the liquid solution can be stored. When this is for the soft gelatin, because in hard gelatin capsules, we only store the solid substances, solid excipients along with your active ingredient. That mixture is being powdered substances being stored in the hard gelatin capsules. When the gelatin capsules are have to store the liquid, it is called the soft gelatin capsules. So you can see both the things over here, volume as well as the content milligram. So 000 can actually have the content 950 milligrams, 00 650 milligram. As the number increases, the amount is going to decrease. Then this is for the 000, it is able to store the largest amount, and number 5 is able to store the smallest amount. So generally the hard gelatin capsules are encapsulated between 65 milligrams to the 1 milligram. Largest size are available for veterinary use. Veterinary means for animal purposes, so animal dosage forms. The sizes selected for use is determined by the amount of the fill material to be encapsulated. So it has to be made very clear that what is the amount to be administered to the patient. Suppose 250 milligram needs to be administered to the patient, or like 100 milligram, that will decide what size of the capsule will be manufactured. So it is directly proportional to the dose. So the first we should know the dose of the patient to be administered, then you can select the appropriate size of the capsule accordingly. Now let us try to understand the manufacturing of the first empty gelatin capsules. So when you are now clear about how do you derive the gelatin. Gelatin is derived from collagen obtained from the animal sources and dried bones, calf bone, pork skin, fishes, horses, etc. So once you have obtained the gelatin, now you have to make the empty gelatin shells, whereby you can will fill your powdered substance. So this is the second step that is involved in making empty gelatin capsules, and it is the steps involved these stages. First is dipping, second spinning, third drying, fourth stripping, trimming, polishing and printing. So you can rememberize it very easily by remembering the word DSDSTPP. I'm repeating, by remembering these words DSPSTPP. So first stage is the dipping stage. First stage is the dipping stage. Second is the spinning stage. You can see what is dipping? Your gelatin liquid is being dipped with the pins, whereby it will be making that circular part. So your gelatin is being dipped into the pins, that is a dipping. Then the rotation of the pins is being taken place so that the spherical part or the body part and the capsule part can be formed. This is the spinning part. This is the dipping part, and after this you can see it is being dried out and it is being cut to the desired strength. The body part is being cut to the desired strength, known as the stripping, and then cutting, and then joining of the body and the caps takes place. So again, these stages are very important for the capsules. Now, once your empty gelatin capsules have been made in large scale or the small scale preparations, of second step is the filling of the hard gelatin capsules, and it is divided into following general steps. These are the general steps which is being followed. First is the developing and preparing the formulation. Now you have your empty gelatin shells. Now the second stage will be the preparation of their formulation. Now formulation can be prepared by having the active ingredient along with additional substances known as excipients, that may be ranging from lactose, opacant, titanium dioxide and other things. And once you have the formulation prepared, it will be filled into the capsule shells, filling the capsule shells, then capsule sealing. This is again very important. The body and cap have to be sealed out so that they don't reopen easily. They are being sealed out by tightly pressing and then cleaning and polishing of the filled capsules. So once it has been filled properly, external cleaning of the and polishing of the capsules is being done. So in developing the capsule formulation, the goal is to prepare a capsule with the accurate dose, having good bioavailability, stability and elegance, and ease of filling and production. So while preparing the formulation, these additional substances are added, for example, along with the active ingredient. For example, you are preparing the paracetamol capsules. So along with the paracetamol, you will need to add diluent and fillers. Now, why do we need diluents? Because we want to have the desired weight. So these are the additional filler substances which are being added, for example, the lactose, microcrystalline cellulose, starch, etc. And then apart from that, you can also add disintegrants. Disintegrants like pre-gelatinized starch, cross carmelose. You can remember at least 2 to 3 examples. Cross carmelose, sodium starch, glycolate, etc. They are being added so that your disintegration parts become easy. Until it is being disintegrated, it will not be absorbed. So once your capsule cell comes in contact with your gastrointestinal fluid, the fluid will disintegrate the outer gelatin shell. Then your medicament will come and it will immediately disintegrate so that you can have the effect. And other things which are added is like lubricant or glidants. For example, silicon dioxide, magnesium stearate, calcium stearate, etc. Then surface active agents like sodium lauryl sulfate. SLS is generally added to facilitate the wetting by the gastrointestinal fluid. Then other desiccant material is like dried silica gel, activated charcoal to protect the capsules against absorption of the atmospheric moisture. What happens is that once you have manufactured the capsules, to avoid from the atmospheric condition, suppose the high atmosphere, you have the high humidity, what will happen? It will absorb the moisture from the atmospheric condition. So if you incorporate this substance, desiccant material, into your formulation, it will not allow this material will not allow the external absorption of the moisture from the atmospheric part. Now you have prepared it. These are the machines which are being used. When we talk about the machine, we have this hand-filled machine. Hand-operated machine whereby you can there is a tray. You can see this tray is there, loading tray. You have pens also there. So at least you can just fill your empty gelatin capsule shells. The body part is being done, cap part is put away, and then you fill your material, whatever is being desired, after having thorough calculation, and then you press it tightly, and then your capsule shell will be mated in your lab. You must have seen this type of the hand operated machine in your labs. Then semi-automatic machine, partial operations are semi-automatic. For example, you will be filling your body part, you will be filling your cap part, then your medicament also, so that they are being filled automatically and they are being sealed out and the capsules is being prepared accordingly. Now the famous capsule filling machines are like from the Eli Lilly and Company, Pharmatic. Try to memorize few examples because questions are generally being asked in the competitive exams as well as in your routine examinations. For example, the company like Eli Lilly, Pharmatic, Hofliger and Krakag, Janassi is very famous, Parker Davis. Now, once you have actually filled up it, now the other methods of capsule sealings, like the sealing part is very important. Now, you have filled up your empty gelatin capsule shells with your formulated medicament. You have filled it. Now comes the sealing part. Sealing part is very important because until and unless the capsule is sealed properly, the patient can take it properly because it has to go for the transportation also, like other pressures are also there. So it may happen that it may reopen. So to prevent that, we need to seal the capsules very properly. Now there are various sealing techniques, like you can seal it with your gelatin also, like distinct looking capsules by sealing them with a colored band of the gelatin, also known as the cap seals. So if removed, the band cannot be restored without expert sealing with the gelatin. Or you can have the heat welding process also. Now this heat will actually help in the fusion of the capsule cap to the body. So your empty gelatin capsule shell is actually exposed to the heat and the both seals out body and the cap part. And other techniques are also there, like melting point lowering, liquid wetting agent in the contact of areas of the capsule cap and body, then thermally bonds the two. So there are many techniques, but generally used are like use of your sealing with a gelatin or like heat welding processes. Now, once you have sealed it up, the second task is the polishing. The polishing, all the prepared capsules are then polished using the Axella Cotta pan, which is used to dust and polish. Axella Cotta pan. Then they are being brushed upon. Capsules are fed under soft rotating brush. Then finished capsules normally contain equilibrium moisture of 13 to 16. This is the desired moisture content which is required after the preparation of the capsules. Then the dusting part is also very important. The storing part is important. You have to maintain the humidity within 40 to 60%. So this is the automatic filling operation. You can see that suppose there are two or four ingredients: ingredient lactose, titanium dioxide, active ingredient, lubricants. They are being mixed and sieved out properly. They are being blended properly. So this mix then goes to the powdered blend. Empty capsules from the other end are coming. Then the capsule filter machine is actually adding your powder into your empty gelatin capsule shells. Then they are being screened out. They are being quality control tests like weighing system, finished capsules, packaging, etc. And hereby the product is finally being packed. So in this diagram, this is the flowchart whereby you can understand the actual operation and filling of your capsules. Now, once your capsules have been prepared, they need to be evaluated. Quality control test. Four tests which are being required in the case of capsules are like weight variation test, content uniformity test, dissolution test, disintegration test. So weight variation test is that in which you take the 20 capsules, they are being weighed, and the standard deviation is being noticed from the average weight. So it should not be less than 90% and not more than 110%. Content uniformity, the amount of the active ingredient should be within the range of 85 to 115% of the labeled amount. 9 of the 10 capsules with no unit outside the range. So you can see in the weight variation, it is allowing that it should not deviate. The weight variation should not deviate by, it should not be less than 90% and not more than 110%. Content uniformity around allowed is 85% to 115%. Then the third test is the disintegration test, whereby they are being capped in the disintegration apparatus, and it should not form a lump. What happens when we talk about the disintegration of the capsules is that when they breaks down, the gelatin shells comes in the form of lumps and the medicament is being absorbed. So the gelatin shell should come out easily and form aside, and the medicament should be easily solubilized in the fluid. Then the dissolution test is also very much required. Now, what are the special applications of these capsules is that they can also be advanced and they can also be customized to make the enteric coated capsules. Now, what are enteric coated capsules? They are the capsules which have their therapeutic action in the small intestine. They are not being disintegrated into the stomach due to the presence of special polymers like SCAP, cellulose acetate phthalates. Now, these substances have the property like that they do not disintegrate in the acidic pH of the stomach. They disintegrate in the alkaline pH of the intestine. So there are the specialized capsules which are will be released their therapeutic property into the intestine part at higher alkaline pH. Then sustained release capsules. Now the normal capsules can also be designed in a way that you have the sustained release capsules, whereby suppose you are taking capsules 3 times a day, then you will not be requiring to take it 3 times a day, only a single capsule for the complete day, which will be releasing the medicament slowly with the help of the various polymers added to that, that will actually control the release of the capsules. Third are the rectal capsules, for example, suppositories, etc. So they are again used for the preparation of suppositories. Then capsule containing ophthalmic ointments. You must have seen that sometimes the soft gelatin capsules are filled up with ointment for the treatment of ocular infections. So there are some special applications of the soft gelatin and the hard gelatin capsules, which is widespread being used. Thank you so much for watching my video. Please do like, share and subscribe Pharmacypedia. Also, please provide your views in the comment box. Stay tuned. Thank you so much.